If I could smoke with anybody, I would smoke with
Bill Clinton.
That's heavy. That's heavy. That's heavy. Motherfucking Oval Office. Yeah, you hear me? Yes, sir. We on the GGN News Network. This is your boy Nemo Holmes, your host with the most, with my nephew Don Kennedy out of Leimert Park. What up, nephew?
Yeah,
what's happening with you?
What up?
Slow motion. What's happening with you?
Man, chilling, enjoying this LA summertime.
Yes,
you know
sir.
What I'm saying? Yellow album is out. We playing that daily.
This is my type of party. Make money like Oprah. Do it big like I'm Sosa. Never drink King Cobra. Getting head on the sofa.
You know what I'm saying? Getting ready to go on the road in the fall, but we should enjoy this summer.
Okay, so you got some plans to go on the road already? You know who you're rolling with and where you going?
I don't know who I'm rolling with, but we gonna start in Europe in October. First time in Europe, man. London.
And one thing about the people over there, they really appreciate, you know, West Coast hip hop for real. Mm-hmm. I've been doing it for like 20 years going over there, and they love it. It's a dude in London named Westwood that you definitely need to go see.
Okay.
And Mr. Jam.
Okay.
Go check on both of them dudes, cause they really probably got you popping over there. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know, but I probably know this for a fact that they bang your shit, cause they bang anything that's West that sound good.
Yeah.
So make sure you reach out for them, at least get somebody to try to get them to come see you.
Nah, we gonna do that for sure.
Don, what was some of your influences in the rap game or music in general before you got your feet wet?
Man, Quick. You know, just being a LA dude, man. Quick, Cube, Dog Pound. You know, Jay-Z, Nas, Biggie Smalls. That's really, you know, the mainstays. People that I listen to, you know, that's remain, you know, throughout the game. Like, it was a lot of people that came and went, but those is like, you know, you can't go without
solidified. Yeah, that was my thing, too.
Yeah.
Quick and Cube, because they was, like, the closest thing to what I wanted to be.
Mm-hmm.
And then and what was so crazy was, like, a couple times I went into some meetings, because I had a couple of homies that was kind of sharp. And they was like my manager and shit, so they took me to a couple of little Hollywood meetings and played my music.
Mm-hmm.
Motherfucker was like, nah, he don't sound like DJ Quick. I was like, damn, that's fucked up. But it was inspiring.
That's what they
was looking exactly, for. It was inspiring, so it sent me back on a mission, like to try to like find what he was doing. His shit had a groove, nigga. Mm-hmm. His shit had groove, nigga. His shit was moving and it had fun. It was, he was talking that hood shit. I was like, okay, I got it. I know what's happening. I got it. Helped me tighten my shit up. Mm-hmm. But he had a mixtape, right? He had a blood mixtape.
I never heard that.
Oh my God,
he was dissing. Somebody gotta give me that.
Nigga, he was dissing the Crip.
I never heard that.
But it was so hard. Nigga, every nigga in my neighborhood was like, it was so hard. It was so real.
Yeah.
It's like the shit he was saying, it was, and then right, like the motherfucking, the peace treaty happened like right after that, so it was like it was so appropriate because he was banging so hard.
Mm.
It was so real. That was harder than his first album. And then some of that shit he did on that mixtape, he used on his first album, but he just cleaned it up. He took the gangbang out and made it more like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, universal.
But it was fun though. And it's like, see, when you was out there gangbanging, you respect a hard nigga.
Yeah, because you hear it.
You don't respect a weenie, you respect a hard nigga. So when him dissing and coming hard and banging, even as a Crip nigga, we respected him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like that nigga going hard.
Jamaica? Wow, it's Remember Me Real. A lot of beaches, cool people, woo, and hot weather. Very hot and warm.
I look for a blank in a woman.
Good tacos.
She got to be able to cook.
Cook tacos, at least. Like that. That's the minimum
okay,
for LA.
Okay, do you want the taco? Okay, I gotta fuck with you because you're talking some real shit now. You want the hard shell tacos or do you want the flour tacos with the butter on them? with the cheese melted with the ground beef. You hit me with the tomatoes and a little bit of sour cream on there.
They usually, around the way we be at, they usually make the hard ones.
The hard ones?
The hard ones. Yeah, the hard tacos with the, you know, with everything on the fresh lettuce.
I got you.
The fresh chopped lettuce, shredded cheese, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, diced tomatoes.
So you ain't never had a shooby-dooby come through and hook you up a flour with the butter?
Nah, I haven't.
Man.
I can't say I have. I seen it.
You get that?
That's the one.
Look here. You see what that do? You wrap that thing up. You spin him around like a burrito Cholito. You understand me? And that, oh, Lord have mercy.
That's it.
I'm going to have one hook something
man,
up for
we
you.
We got to do that.
Me? Yeah. Mm. No disrespect to the hard taco, because that's what I fuck with at Taco Bell. When I go to Del Taco, I get them soft
them
tacos.
Soft ones
yeah,
going
Del
up.
Taco.
Them chickens.
Hello.
Yes, that Del
yeah.
Taco.
Yeah. Late night, 2 yeah. in the morning?
Yeah.
Del Taco, you was a bad motherfucker, Del. I got to get Del a shout out. My nigga Del. Thursday, $3 for $1.
Thursday.
What's today? Don't say no shit like that, nigga. We can't get it done. Taco Bell been around for years, man. My homeboys, the twins, used to be the manager of Taco Bell off PCH. We used to get out of school and come down there and get a gang of free shit.
Tacos.
You know what I'm saying? And they come to the back door. Hook a nigga up. Them Bell Beefers? Nigga don't remember the Bell Beefer? That was a hamburger with the taco meat on it. On a bun. It was called a Bell Beefer.
And Bell Beefers old school, man. Google the Bell Beefer. Watch what pops up, nigga. You think I'm bullshit, nigga. Google the Bell Beefer, nigga. I ain't Bell making Beefer. No shit up. Nigga, there
the
he is,
Bell
nigga.
Bell Beefer. That's like the Sloppy Joe.
Exactly. That's exactly what it
was.
Wow,
that's crazy.
That's what it was. It was a Sloppy Joe.
That's crazy. What if they bring it back? You gotta go connect with them.
You're right, because ain't nobody up on there right now.
You can do the whole
Snoop Dogg
campaign.
Bell Beefer.
And I read the whole campaign.
That's right, y'all. You know more In-N-Out burgers, no more Jack in the Box, no more of that bullshit. We're bringing that Bell Beefer back.
Here it is.
Okay.
Cut it.
Hey, I'm Dina. Look at my feet. My feet are straight ahead. You don't want to do that. You want to turn your feet out, and I'm going to do this backwards. And that's what makes it look like hip hop. What this is with hip hop is everything's down low. It all is in a plie.
Oh,
I think the first thing that you need to know about hip hop, it's all about your posture. And hip hop is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, hit. Ah. And ah. The more relaxed you are, that's what makes it hip hop. This is the first thing I will say to you. You want to do hip hop? You got to stand like this. In a hip hop head, we have this. Boom, bam, every time, or. Your hands are always, like this. Start out just hitting it, I took some of this from an African piece. In the African piece, it was like this, but in hip hop, it's like this. See, there's a difference.
Look at this bullshit.
All in your attitude, it's right here in your faces and how you dress, it's the way you look. I want to tell you another thing that makes hip-hop hip-hop.
Oh my God.
I do this at the end of class, every class. I hit here, and I hit here, hit here, peace, I'm out.
How the fuck is she teaching hip-hop? You punk bitch, you. What the fuck do you know about hip hop? You fuck. Fuck, you watch Breaking and think you know about hip hop? You put on an Adidas sweatsuit, bitch, and think that's hip hop? Fuck out of here. I'm not following you.
Yeah, yeah, check me out. Dopeisdom.com. DOPEITSDOM.com. Download that yellow album, theyellowalbum.com. Follow me on Twitter at Dopeisdom. You know what I'm saying? Check me out. Say what up. Make sure y'all download that yellow album, though. For real, for real. If you ain't already got it, tell them Big Snoop Dogg sent you. You know what I'm saying? Lamar Park was cool. Want to say that all day. OPM till it's over. Yeah.
Rastafari.
Them a walk and a talk about this a one. Them a laugh and go on about that a one. Hey, what you want, you can't get it, get it. And the problem will get real dready, dready. Say,
who feels it knows? And I suppose that you never know. Oh, you reap what you sow. Can't plant a corn when the bees won't fit grow. No. La 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 la. Oh yeah.
Church. Preach. Tabernacle.